Hi, I'm Russ. Today we're going to talk about suppressor malfunctions and how to prevent them. First, let's talk common sense. There are two certainties in life. One, you can't push a golf ball through a garden hose. And two, you can't push a 9mm peg through a 7.62 hole. So please, for your safety and the safety of those around you, take a moment to ensure that you're using the proper muzzle device for your weapon system, caliber, and suppressor. Now, can you guess the number one cause of suppressor failure? If you guessed improper muzzle device installation, you are correct. If your muzzle device is not tight enough, it will walk off the barrel, causing the suppressor to sag. And we all know what happens to a suppressor that's not aligned. It gets a strike. You spent some serious money and waited months to get your suppressor. The quickest way to blow your investment is to install your can improperly. If you're ever nervous about your suppressor not being aligned, we recommend that you get an alignment rod to check it out. Now, let's talk muzzle device installation. Use acetone to clean the threads on the muzzle device and barrel. When installing any muzzle device, we highly recommend using a red high temp thread locker such as Loctite or Vibratite. Add the thread locker to the barrel threads, then thread on the muzzle device until it's hand tight. Using the flats on the bottom of the muzzle device, use an adjustable wrench to turn the muzzle device from 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock, which is about 15 degrees or 33 foot-pounds of torque. Once the Loctite is cured, you're ready to use your suppressor. Okay, that's all you need to make sure your suppressor is mounted properly. Be safe out there and happy shooting.